Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello friends, welcome to the channel DevDbQa.com. In this video, we are going to learn about smoke testing overview, sanity testing overview, and smoke testing versus sanity testing. So guys, let's start. First of all, smoke testing. Smoke testing comes into the picture at the time of receiving build software from the development team. So the smoke testing is performed at the time of receiving the build or the software from the dev team. The purpose of smoke testing is to determine whether the build software is testable or not. So the main purpose of smoke testing is to determine that the software, the build that is delivered from the dev team is testable or not. This process is also known as day zero, because day zero is called, smoke testing is called as day zero because it is performed before the start of the testing cycle to check that the software that is received from the dev team is testable or not. If the software is not testable, then there is no point of wasting the time in testing the complete software. Then we will return the software back to the dev team to fix the defects. It is a time saving process. It reduces testing time because testing is done only when the key features of the application are not working or if the key bugs are not fixed. So this process, the smoke testing, is a time saving process, because in smoke testing we test that the build that is received from the dev team to the testing team is testable or not. If the build is not testable, then there is no point of testing the complete application for the defects or bugs. Only when the main functionalities or the primary functionalities of the application are working, then only the benefit of testing the complete application. The focus of smoke testing is on the workflow of the core and primary functions of the application. So in smoke testing, we focus on the testing of the core and primary functions of the application, the main or important functions of the applications. If the main functions are not working properly, then there is no point of testing the other not so important functions of the application. Next is sanity testing. Sanity testing is performed at the time of receiving software build with minor changes in the code from the dev team. So the smoke testing is performed at the very first step before the start of the testing life cycle, whereas the sanity testing is performed when we received a build or the software from the dev team with some minor changes in the code. The purpose of sanity testing is to ensure that all the defects have been fixed and no further issue come in existence due to these changes. So the purpose of smoke testing is to test that the defects that were fixed by the dev team have not induced any other defect in the already working functionality of the application or the software. It is a kind of regression testing with a focus on few impacted functionalities only. So in sanity testing, we only test the impacted functionalities of the software. The impact that the fixed bug or the new functionality that is added in the software that can impact the other already working functionalities, that type of functionalities we only test in the sanity testing. Sanity testing can be done in two situations. One, in the case of enhancement in the functionality, and second is the case of defect fixed. So there are two situations in which we have to perform sanity testing. Number one is the enhancement in the functionality. So if there is any enhancement in the previous functionality, then we perform the sanity testing to check that the functionality is working fine and there are no impact on the other functionalities of the software. And the second point is in the case of defect fixed. So if there is a defect in the software, then it is given to the dev team and they fix the defect. So the tester will test the application using the Sanity testing to check that there is no impact of the fixed defect on the other working functionalities of the software. It makes sure that the changes made in code or functions have no impact on the related modules. Therefore, it can be applied only on related modules that can be impacted. So the Sanity testing makes sure that the code or function changes that are done by the dev team have no impact on the already working modules of the software. So in Sanity testing, we only test the related modules that can be impacted by the bug fixes or the new functionality introduction into the software. So now guys, we will see the differences between smoke testing and sanity testing. Number one point is, it is a broad approach to test where all parts of applications are tested. So in smoke testing, we will check all the main important and the primary functions of the software, that they are working fine or not. If they are not working fine, then we will not proceed further with our testing. We will return the build to the dev team to fix the defects. Whereas in sanity testing, it is a narrow approach to test where specific parts of the applications are tested. So in sanity testing, only the specific parts of the application are tested where there is a defect fix or there is any introduction of new functionality in the software. Second point is, it measures the stability of the system by performing rigorous testing. So in smoke testing, the stability of the system is tested by performing rigorous testing of the software. So in we can check that the system or the software is stable or not using the smoke testing. Whereas in sanity testing, it measures the rationality of the system by performing rigorous testing. So rationality means the software is performing as expected or not. So we check that the software is working as expected or not in the sanity testing. Third point is, smoke testing can be either manual or automated. So we can perform the smoke testing manually or automatically also. So in automatically, we design the automation scripts to test the software, and only the main important priority one scripts will be executed for smoke testing. Whereas in sanity testing can be done without test cases or test scripts. Because in sanity testing, we have to test manually, and the impacted functionalities or if the defect fixes, we have to test them manually, and it can also be automated with the help of automation scripts. It is performed by both testers and developers. So the smoke testing is performed by both developers and testers as well, whereas the sanity testing is performed only by the testers. Fifth point is, smoke testing is done without getting into deep, but whenever needed, tester has to go into deep. So in the smoke testing, the main or the core functionality of the software are tested, but in some cases the tester has to go in the deep testing of the software to check that the functionality is working fine or not. Whereas sanity testing does not need to go into deep of the application. So as we see that this in smoke testing, the tester in sometimes have to go into deep for testing the software, whereas in sanity testing, there is no need to go much deeper into the application. Smoke testing is documented, whereas sanity testing is not documented. So the smoke testing is performed by tester or developers, then it is documented, whereas the sanity testing is not documented by the testers. It is used to test end-to-end function of the application. So smoke testing is used to test the end-to-end functionality of the application, whereas sanity testing is used to test only modified or defect fixed functions. Last point is, it is considered as a subset of acceptance testing, and sanity testing is considered as a subset of regression testing. So smoke testing is considered as a subset of acceptance testing, because in smoke testing we are accepting or rejecting the build that we got from the development team. whereas in sanity testing it is considered as the subset of regression testing, because we are testing only the impacted functionalities of the software that may be impacted by the defect fix or with any new introduction of functionality in the software. So guys, in today's video we learned about smoke testing overview, sanity testing overview, and smoke testing versus sanity testing. So guys, the smoke testing versus sanity testing is a very important interview question, and it is asked by many interview questions for manual testing. So guys, please read it carefully, and if you like my video then please hit the like button, please subscribe and press the bell icon to regularly get the updates, and if you have any suggestions then please comment in the comment section. So guys, thank you for watching my video.